Today we're talking about Dale Bredesen's ReCODE protocol, the first program to prevent and reverse cognitive decline. But before we do, please make sure to subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. It's really important to please the Google algorithms. And now to the good stuff. Here's a really good metaphor from the book of what's going on in your brain in most cases of cognitive decline. Let's pretend you have a house with 36 leaky holes in the roof. You call the repairman, he gets on the roof. He fixes one or two of the holes. Is your leaky roof fixed? Of course not. Alzheimer's is like a roof with leaks all over the place. Alzheimer's medication is like the repairman who comes and patches one or two of the leaks. The medication isn't enough to fix all the holes. In fact, by the time the book was published, Bredesen had identified 36 leaky holes in the brain. That's one leaky roof. So how do you patch those leaks? First, Bredesen recommends you find a medical provider to work with. Even if they haven't been trained in the ReCODE protocol, they can still read Bredesen's work and run the recommended tests and help you interpret the results. These tests will help determine what Alzheimer's subtype you have, which then tells you where to focus your efforts. As we discussed in my previous video, Bredesen argues there are three main types of Alzheimer's: hot, cold, and toxic. So what do you need to figure out through testing? Your homocysteine levels, your vitamin B6, B12, and folate levels, your fasting insulin and glucose levels, the ratio of albumin to globulin in your blood, the ratio of omega-6 to omega-3s in your red blood cells, and your interleukin-6 and tumor necrosis factor alpha levels, your vitamin D3 levels, how your thyroid's functioning, estradiol, progesterone, and testosterone levels, your copper-zinc ratio, level of magnesium in your red blood cells, selenium and glutathione levels. What's your heavy metal exposure, including mercury, lead, arsenic, and cadmium, exposure to mycotoxins, cholesterol levels, vitamin E and B1 levels, leaky gut or gluten sensitivities, body mass index, sleep apnea, and the effect current medications might have on your memory. If this sounds overwhelming, just remember the leaky roof. You focus on patching the most critical holes first and work out from there. Testing helps you figure out which holes to focus on. While working with your doctor, there are a lot of other things you can do on your own, including a low glycemic, low inflammatory diet, which means no sugars, no grains, and careful with fruits. At least a 12-hour fast each night, starting 3 hours before bedtime. That means no bedtime snacks or late dinners. Eliminate stress as much as possible. Exercise 4 to 6 days a week, 30 to 60 minutes a day. Improve gastrointestinal health, gut repair, prebiotics and probiotics, bone broth and stock. Sleep at least 8 hours a night. Consume healthy fats. Be careful with dairy. You want to eat cultured grass-fed products like kefir, cultured cream, or yogurt, without the sugars or stabilizers, of course. If you eat red meat, go for grass-finished meat. It has a higher omega-3 content than grain-finished meat. Eat lots of good leafy greens and cruciferous vegetables like cabbage, broccoli, kale, etc. And last, but probably the most important, find a supportive network of people who will not only help you make these changes, but take the journey with you as well. So there you have it, a basic overview of what Bredesen recommends you test for, and lifestyle changes that are helpful in reversing Alzheimer's. Again, I recommend picking up his book, and I sincerely hope you can find medical professionals who will help you, as well as support from friends and family. Thanks for watching. You can watch parts 1 and 2 of this series by clicking on the links below. Make sure to subscribe because I'll be doing one more video with an overall assessment of Bredesen's work, and until next time,